Hello, my dear friends. I am Dr. Osama Ibrahim from Easy and Different Radiology. Welcome back in the Radiological Anatomy. Actually, today I will talk about episode 4 for Pillary System Anatomy. I will discuss with you today some expressions like duct of Santorini, duct of Fersing, pancreatic divism, annular pancreas, MRCP, and ERCP. So let's get started. The learning objective from my presentation is talking about anatomy of the pillary system, definitions of ERCP and MRCP, what the duct of Wiersing and Santorini representing, embryology of the pancreas, a little bit embryology, to talk about some diseases like annular pancreas or pancreatic divism, and at the end there are test yourself, two slides for test yourself. This diagram representing the anatomy of the pillary system. As you know, the pillary system is represented by the pancreatic duct and the pillary system, pillary ducts, which excretes their juice into the GIT tracts to helping in the digestion of food. So first one is representing the ducts, and two is representing the intrahepatic pillary ducts, and these three and four representing the left hepatic duct and right hepatic duct, and they are connected together to form the common hepatic duct. And disease 9 is representing the gallbladder, and the gallbladder is excrete their juice through the cystic duct and join with the common hepatic duct to form the common bile duct. Common bile duct is connected with the main pancreatic duct before they enters together to the ampulla of Vater in the second part of the duodenum through the major papillae. Sometimes there are accessory pancreatic duct, which is called duct of Santorini, which opened at the minor papillae at the site just above to the major papillae site in the second part of the duodenum also. The pancreatic duct is formed by the main pancreatic duct, which is connected to the duct in the head of the pancreas to open at the second part of the duodenum at the major papillae. And this duct is called the Santorini duct. This is the duodenum, and this is the duodenojejunal junctions, and this is part from the jejunum. And this part is the esophagus, stomach, first part of the duodenum, second part of the duodenum, third part, and fourth part. What is the meaning of ERCP? It representing this one modality for imaging of the pillary system, and E is endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography, is a procedure used to diagnose the disease of the gallbladder, pillary system, pancreas, and liver. However, MRCP is representing magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography, and this is non-invasive technique to visualize the intra and extrahepatic pillary tree and the pancreatic ductal system. It can provide the diagnostic range equivalent to the ERCP, and so it can replace the ERCP in high risk patients to avoid significant morbidity. And this is the image of the ERCP, which depends on the endoscopic way to inject the contrast retrograde within the ampulla of Vater, and the contrast passing through the pancreatic duct and the common bile duct, and the imaging is the pillary system. And this is radiographic, meaning X-ray or fluoroscopy. However, this image is representing MRCP, magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography, and this image is non-invasive, which shows the pancreatic duct, common bile duct opening within the ampulla of Vater also, as which is equivalent to that image. So this is the two studies, which the studies of choice to imaging the pylori system. I will talk a little bit about the embryology to understand the meaning of some expressions. At the 5-week embryology, there are two pancreatic bud, and this pancreatic bud is one of them is dorsal, and the duct which passing through it is called the accessory dorsal pancreas, which opened within the second part of the duodenum. However, the ventral pancreatic segments have another duct, and this duct is the main duct and opened at the major papilla in the second part of the duodenum after conjoined with the common bile duct. However, at the end of 6 weeks of embryo, there are transformations or rotations of that ventral duct or of the duodenum, and the ventral duct now fused with the dorsal duct of the pancreas and become the main pancreatic duct. And this duct is the accessory pancreatic duct, which is become rudimentary or small and opens in the minor papillae only. So the main pancreatic duct of Weyersinck is distal portion of the main pancreatic duct. Segment of the ventral duct between the dorsal ventral fusions points and the major papillae, it representing the Weyersinck duct, continuous with the main pancreatic duct proximally. As we'll see here in that diagram, this is the pancreas before rotation of the duodenum, ventral pancreas and dorsal pancreas. Each one have its duct which opens within the second part of the duodenum. After rotation, this ventral portion is fused with that dorsal portion, and the main pancreatic duct opened within the minor papillae here, within the duct of Santorini. However, the other duct of the ventral portion is opened in the major papillae after fusion with the common bile duct. After union of the ducts here, the pancreatic duct is representing a main pancreatic duct and opened in the second part of the duodenum at ampulla of Vetter at the major papillae after conjoined with the common bile duct. However, the accessory pancreatic duct is represented by this portion, which is called of duct of Santorini. So, if there are no fusion between the ventral duct or no rotations between the ventral pancreas and the dorsal pancreas, it causing disease which is called annular pancreas, surrounding the second part of the duodenum from both sides. As that image of CT, and this high potency area representing the second part of the duodenum, and there are ventral portion from the pancreas and dorsal portion from the pancreas. Both are found on both sides of the duodenum, and this is which is called the annular pancreas. Annular pancreas develops due to failure of ventral bud to rotate with the duodenum, causing encasement of the duodenum. This encasement sometimes causes pancreatitis due to narrowing or obstruction of the drainage of the pancreatic juice. Now, what is the accessory dorsal duct of Santorini? As we see it in the diagram, that is the portion of the dorsal duct distal to the dorsal ventral fusion point, drains anterior and superior portion of the head. In 70% of individuals, drains to the minor papilla. However, in the 30% of individuals, persists as a branch of the main pancreatic duct. So, what is the dorsal duct of Santorini? This is the duct which is connecting the main duct of the pancreas directly through the minor papilla of the second part of the duodenum. And the other duct of the ventral portion of the pancreas is drained also at the major papilla of the duodenum. So these separations is leading to disease which is called pancreatic dephysem. Pancreatic dephysem meaning separate opening of the duct of Santorini, which drains most of the pancreatic juice within the duodenum through that minor papilla. That is what can cause obstruction of the duct and dilatations, and also can lead to pancreatitis, as we see here in that CT image, due to fat stranding surrounding to the pancreas. It also can cause recurrent pancreatitis in young age. So duct of Santorini, when opened separately within the duodenum, is called pancreatic dephysem. So pancreatic dephysem meaning it results from the failure of the fusion of the dorsal and the ventral pancreatic and legs. As a result, the dorsal pancreatic duct of Santorini drains most of the pancreatic glandular parenchyma via the minor papilla. And this opening is narrow opening, leading to accumulations of secretions of the pancreas within the duct and may cause pancreatitis. Now, at the end, evaluate and test yourself. This is the image diagram. There are multiple numbers here, and these numbers representing anatomical structures. For example, 9 representing what? Representing gallbladder. 22 representing what? Representing left kidney. 17 representing what? Representing the main pancreatic duct. However, 16 representing the duct of Santorini. And this opening representing minor papilla of the duodenum. However, 15 representing head of the pancreas. And so on. You can test yourself and you can return to the answer in the front of the presentation, as the names of these numbers are present. Another one to test the anatomy. This study is called the endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography, or ERCP. However, this one is a MRCP. ERCP, you can see the spine and you can see the tube of endoscopic for injections. Now, what is this arrow represented? It representing the left hepatic duct, which connected with this duct, which is the right hepatic duct, to form the common hepatic duct. And is in connecting with the cystic duct of the gallbladder to form the common bile duct. And is in connecting with the pancreatic duct, the main pancreatic duct, to open within the ampulla of Vater as the second part of the duodenum. Again, what is this arrow is representing? This arrow is representing the main pancreatic duct or duct of Weyersing. What is this oval arrow representing? Or this pink? Here, the same as here in the MRCP and the ERCP. This is representing the ampulla of Vater, or the opening of the common bile duct and the pancreatic duct within the duodenum, second part of the duodenum. This area, this opening is called the ampulla of Vater, or major papilla, major duodenal papilla. What is this arrow represented? In the MRCP, representing the common bile duct. And this one before just distal to the conjunctions between the right and left hepatic duct is called the common hepatic duct. I hope I don't waste your time and provide you with a little bit valuable information about radiological anatomy, biliary system. Thank you very much for watching and have a nice time.